You have to make these lazy noodles. They are literally made in 15 minutes with some water, soy sauce, cornstarch, maple syrup, vinegar, tahini, chili flakes. Blend it all up in a blender or whisk it up in a bowl. Then transfer the mixture into a pan, add the noodles, stir and heat it up until the sauce thickens. Then serve with some fresh herbs or sesame seeds, whatever you like, and there you go. They're so, so, so good. You know this cookie's for the bag. Kitty, kitty, baby, get her things to rest. Cause you done beat her like the 68 Jets. Diamonds are nothing when I'm rockin' with ya. Diamonds are nothing when I'm shinin' with ya. Just keep it white and black as if I'm your sister. I'm too hip to hop around town, I hear with ya. I heard that pussy for the taking. I heard it got these other niggas going crazy. Yeah, I treat you like a lady, lady. Fuck you till you burned out, cremation. Make a cream, yeah, Wu-Tang. Roll that ass back, Wu.
Buttered chicken, but vegan. Take the pressed tofu and tear it into chunks. Add your olive oil and your cornstarch.
Add the tofu to a lined baking sheet.
Now bake your tofu. Let's make the creamy sauce now. Add your vegan butter, add your onions. Saute your onions for 3 to 4 minutes. Add your garlic and ginger, curry powder, garam masala, paprika, coriander, pinch of salt, tomato paste, whole fat coconut milk.
And simmer for 10 minutes.
Add your baked tofu
and stir.
You're gonna wanna try this.
Okay, but seriously, how easy it is to make homemade pita bread. Once you have the starter, you literally have to combine all of it in a blender, or you can do it by hand. I just never feel like kneading the dough. And yeah, you're gonna let it rest for 2 hours. You can do whatever you want during that time. And now this is the most satisfying part. Okay, you're gonna wanna divide it into 6 little like balls and let it rest again for like 15 to 30 minutes. Roll it out. Put it on a hot pan and make a beautiful stack of pita bread. It's delicious and you can use it for everything.
Notes to self: always buy tofu from the Asian market. Cornstarch will make the tofu crispy. Don't be afraid to use garlic and ginger. Recipe coming soon. Make chili oil at home. Grease the tofu to resemble the chicken texture. There is no I don't like tofu. Just say you don't know how to cook it. Food is love.
Mm-hmm. Very good.
Welcome to the first ever episode of Fuck That's Vegan, where we cook food that will make you say, fuck, that's vegan. On today's recipe, we're making some chicken wings. Obviously not your average. The star ingredient in this recipe is jackfruit. To get this started, I marinated up some jackfruit and then fried it off. Once you got some nice colour on it, hit it with some stock. And to be honest, at this point, it'd be really good for like a pie or something like that. Once your mixture's had time to cool down, stick it inside some rice paper. This is gonna act like our chicken skin. After that, you wanna pané it up. Now, pané is just a fancy word for saying breadcrumb. You need a little bit of milk, some breadcrumbs, and some flour. Fry that off like it's 420, and whoo-hoo, it should come out looking crazy. To finish it off, I hit it with a little bit of vegan mayo, some barbecue sauce, hot sauce, herbs, spices, lemon, and of course, that smoke.
I don't know if it's just my mom or brown moms in general, but she cannot waste anything. Like, she'll eat a banana and then rub the entire peel on her face, or she'll find leftover beer and use it as a shampoo. And during the summer when we're eating a lot of watermelon, she'll save all our rinds and make tarbuski sabji. And I cannot explain how good this is, and it's so easy because all you do is boil your rinds for 20 minutes and in the same pan toast cumin seeds, asafoetida, turmeric, coriander, and red chili powder. Then add your rinds back in and finish with dried mango powder and salt. And that's it, edible watermelon rinds. First of all, I did not know you could make pretzels at home. Second of all, I did not know they were vegan. This recipe calls for 1.5 cups of lukewarm water with a packet of instant dry yeast and a tablespoon of sugar. Let that get frothy, then add in 1 teaspoon of salt and 2 cups of flour. Mix it up and add in another 2 cups of flour. Someone said you could use a hand mixer. That was a lie. I don't like that person. After the dough is mixed, you're going to knead it out on a floured surface and let it rise for 10 minutes. And then you're going to knead it a couple more times and just cut it in half and roll it into these little logs where you can cut 1-inch pieces. And now we're going to put them into a bath of hot water and 1/2 cup of baking soda for about 30 seconds. Take them out, brush them in olive oil, sprinkle on some coarse salt, and cook them at 425 for 13 minutes. And baby, I'm a little German chef now. Look at me go.
This is how to make a smoothie bowl without bananas.
One of the most common questions I get asked as a vegan is if I miss the taste of meat. But being vegan, you can still enjoy all the flavors you once did. While the meat gives a particular texture, their dominant flavors are the plant-based spices we put on top of them. The barbecue on your wings, the sauce in your curry, the seasoning and toppings in your burrito. All these same flavors we can put on plant-based alternatives. So as a vegan, you don't miss anything at all, except the animal suffering. For more healthy plant-based recipes, head to my Instagram where I post recipes daily.
I feel like Alu Gobi gets a lot of love and attention, which I get, we stan. But let me introduce you to her lesser known cousin, Alu Patta Gobi, where we swap out the cauliflower for cabbage. And I don't know if it's just me, but I get picture-worthy poops after eating a lot of cabbage. So anyways, all you do is add your aromatics, potatoes, turmeric, coriander powder, red chili powder, peas, but that's optional, salt, tomatoes, cabbage, top with lemon juice, and that's it. Serve it with some roti and spinach dal, which I'll be showing next. I'm sick and tired of seeing bland khichdi recipes everywhere, and I just want you to know that you can make your khichdi flavorful and still do your Gwyneth Paltrow detox, Ayurvedic cleanse, whatever you want to call it. I'm begging you to add some flavor, and it's actually really easy. My family has a few khichdi recipes with different techniques, but this one's my favorite. You take equal parts of rice and dal, and I used a blend of 5 different dals, but you can use whatever you have. Then cook your onion, garlic, chilies, tomatoes, spices like asafoetida, add any veggies, and pressure cook for 7 minutes. Top it with some sumac, which gives it a fruity and tangy balance. And yeah, that's it. You can stop eating bland khichdi now.
Too much air in the house? Let's make air potatoes. A large potato cut into chopstick thin slices. Add 1 teaspoon of salt. Marinate for 10 minutes. It's a very juicy potato. Get rid of the water and dry with a kitchen towel. They should be very soft and tender. Add 1 tablespoon of corn or potato starch. Now the coating is watery. Add 2 more tablespoons of starch. Now the coating should be dry. Dip a slice of potato into the oil. When it bubbles rapidly around the potato, it's ready for frying. Fry over medium heat until everyone is floating. Heat up the oil over high heat. Fry the potatoes a second time until they turn into crispy, puffy pillows. Succeed on the first try.
This recipe is for all my vegan besties, but also everyone else, because you don't have to be vegan to eat something without meat in it, especially when it's this delicious. I was inspired by the Japanese agadashi tofu dish. It's my favorite way to eat silk tofu, so we're gonna take that and we're gonna put our own spin on it. First, let's marinate our tofu cubes in some soy sauce-based spicy marinade overnight. The next day, set the tofu between some paper towels to dry while we make the other components. For the zucchini, use a peeler and a knife to turn them into thin, noodle-like strips, then blanch it so it's fully cooked but still has that texture. Pat it dry, season it, and then set it aside. For one of our sauces, we're doing a simple tahini-based sauce. Then for a second sauce, take the marinade and reduce it to a glaze. For our main component, toss your tofu cubes in some flour and cornstarch and fry them up. Place your golden cube of tofu in the middle of some zucchini strips, twist it on top all together to make a messy bun, and then drizzle over the 2 sauces.